Yep, that's me, and you're probably wondering how I got in this situation. Well, luckily I was able to survive all of the mobs that are going to Target trying to grab all the Cosmic Eclipse packs, and I could grab 5 boxes just for your viewing pleasure, so sit back and enjoy. Okay, so here's the fucking deal with this whole video. As you can see, there's clearly no sound going on whatsoever, and after I recorded everything, I was in OBS, and I noticed, well, no, it was after I recorded. I put the video in Premiere, and then I noticed there's no sound. I went back to OBS, and here we are. So, I'm trying to salvage this situation. I'm so fucking mad about all of this, especially because it has to deal with Cosmic Eclipse. Like, this couldn't have happened at a worse time. So fuck technology. I know the world's out to get me. That's usually how it works. So the best I can do is kind of explain what's going on, and hopefully you guys still can kind of get through this video with me. If not, I don't even know why I do this anymore. it's like there's always some sort of roadblock that wants to get in my way. It's just so aggravating and tiring sometimes. It drives me nuts. So yeah, here I am. I'm just like, all right, let's get this shit going. And yeah, all I'm doing here, I'm literally just explaining what's going to be in this box. Clearly we can see that there's 2 Vivid Voltage packs, 1 Cosmic Eclipse pack, and 1 Evolutions, Evolving Skies, not Evolutions, what the fuck I said that for. also, yeah, so I'm also talking about how, like, these Galarian Rapidash boxes, I'm pretty sure came out either like right after Battle Styles, or like I think it was right before Chilling Rain, only because Chilling Rain has that Rapidash card in it. So I remember picking these up in GameStop, and the copyright on the bottom of the card says 2011. Oh my god, 2021. Jesus, if it said 2011, it'd be nuts. Yeah, here's the Galarian Rapidash card. I'm sure we've all seen it by now. It's, you know, it's there. Whatever, cool. And then, oh yeah, this is where I talk about the 2011. 2021, oh my god, fuck me, I can't get it right. Sorry, holy shit. Yeah, anyway, so, yeah, here's just the giant version of the card. I don't even know what to do with these now that I have 5 of these jumbo cards. I'm pretty sure I have 1 in, like, one of my binders from when I was getting, like, the starter sets. You know, those starter Pokemon things that come with 3 jumbo cards and then a couple of packs inside. I don't know. So, yeah, this is just... Oh, look at all that glory. Cosmic Eclipse. Oh, the baby Pokemon. Oops, fuck you. Dropped on the ground. Yeah. So, yeah, 1 Evolving Skies, 1 Cosmic Eclipse pack. 2 Vivid Voltage, and yeah, well, I also discussed, like, the price. So obviously Cosmic Eclipse packs are going for like $14 right now. Evolving Skies are going for $7.50, so it's like $21. Those two packs alone are worth more than the box itself. The boxes are only going for $18, which is crazy to me. I'm gonna hopefully go to the store tomorrow. I know they're supposed to have the new, like, Annihilate EX boxes that are coming out. I'm hoping that they stocked that with these. If so, I'll probably just grab 1 Annihilate EX box, because I don't care about Scarlet and Violet that all that much. But, you know, I'm just gonna grab it to grab it. And then if I happen to find these there with them, I'm 100% doing it. Alright, So, we skipped all the bullshit. I did all the opening of the packages. Here you got 10 Vivid Voltage packs, 5 Cosmic Eclipse, and 5 Evolving Skies packs. Yeah, whatever. I'm just going over the count. It's nothing special. I mean, it's rough. It's rough to go through Vivid Voltage. I know, I think what I'm talking about here is like when I would, God, I think back in the day, like a couple of years ago, I would try to find these fucking packs and I couldn't. And then I think a game shop was like selling them for $7 a pack. And boy, that was a fucking mistake. That's for sure. You know, during the hype, we didn't know any better. I didn't know any better. I definitely picked the wrong time to get back into it, that's for sure. But yeah, you know, so obviously we're just gonna start opening up these Vivid Voltage packs and hopefully we can pull something good. I mean, I already know what's coming. You everyone doesn't but me, because clearly I've done all this, so. Alright, we got Pineco, Clefairy, Tynamo, Milcery, Meowth, and Blitzel. And ooh, a Talonflame V. Just what we always wanted, a V card. So that's about $1, if that. That's not exciting at all. I don't care. We're just gonna move on to the second pack. There's no reason to listen to me not talk. Like, you literally just see me talking, so. Alright, whatever. Shopit, Poochyena twice, and a non-holo Beedrill. So another garbage pack. Oh, right into the third pack. Whismur, Drillbur, Whalmer, Cottonee, Telescopic Sight, and a Whimsicott non-holo. And I don't miss the non-holos, that's for damn sure. And here, look at me smiling, because I know we're gonna fucking pull bullshit this whole time. Nothing. Like, I just, you know, I have the worst luck. Clearly, this video is an indication of that. So we got Clobopus, Phantump, or Fanpy. What the fuck? It's so hard. So hard to go through this. Rockruff, but, alright. just what we always wanted. And I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? I got another Talonflame V. Out of 5 packs, I got 2 Talonflame V cards. It's like they just want to fuck with me. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. I can't even like seem to like keep it on the table. I just, it falls on the ground, whatever. Whatever. I just wondered if you guys like happened to grab as much Vivid Voltage as I did back in the day, or like thought it was a good set. I mean, at that time, I thought it was good, right? And obviously, that Chocachu was what we wanted. But then that dropped in price a lot. That was $200, I think, at some point. Now it's what, $130, so it's dropped quite a bit. Yeah. Then we got the Pikachu V, and the Pikachu V is another dollar card. I mean, I would... It's a Pikachu, but obviously, that's not what we wanted. But yeah, here I'm like, okay, cool, I could have grabbed it for less anyway. Eevee, Seedot, Drillbur, that thing, and a sweet non-holo that nobody cares about, Magearna. I know holos are just so lame now these days. Like, they're definitely not what they used to be back in the Wizards of the Coast era. And then, oh, an Orbeetle VMAX, that's probably like a $2 card, I don't even remember. I was really hoping I could grab at least like the Pikachu VMAX. Like, that's a decent card. At least it's like a fat version of the Pikachu. But of course we got Orbeetle. Also, I really wish I didn't see any Orbeetle V boxes around in Target or Walmart. I only saw the Rapidash ones. And oh, clearly we got bullshit. So hopefully maybe we can see tomorrow. I asked my brother to see if he is going to Target tomorrow where he lives. Maybe he can grab a couple. I don't know. Hopefully I can grab more. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna move right on to Evolving Skies, or Evolving Cries as everyone likes to call it. This is like the worst pull rates ever in a set. I don't know why. I don't know. With all the good cards in it, I mean, it's just, maybe it's because all that guy stole all the good cards, I'm not sure. So here we go, starting off with a beautiful Elder Goss. Like, surprisingly, we only get, I think, one non-holo out of all these packs. I'm not sure. And then we got another Magearna holo, which, again, trash. It's all bulk at this point. Punkaboo, Bagon, Love Disc, Seedot, Slakoth, Wishiwashi, and a Jolteon VMAX. Oh man, too bad it wasn't the Jolteon VMAX from those Evolution boxes. I'm like, that's not even possible to pull. Like, they're only promo cards. Like, I'm an idiot. So, whatever. Jolteon's fine. I still can't believe that they weren't in this set. Like, they made them promos. But I guess, think about it, right? In the Pokemon 151, the Mewtwo SAR, the gold Mew is going to be a gold metal card. And then the pink Mew card is going to be a promo as well. So it's very interesting that they decided to do that. But yeah, here we go. Duraludon VMAX, another trash card that's worth nothing. Oh my god. And then here we go. This is the main attraction, the five Cosmic Eclipse packs that everybody's talking about. I unfortunately missed the art set. I think I'm missing the three god Pokemon, whatever you want to call them, you know. Oh my god. Sorry, I just came from the gym. I'm fucking tired. But yeah, so these are nice to open. I still have eight packs behind me that are there. I'm like debating if I want to keep them sealed or not. I don't know. We'll see. And then, so there's a reason why I keep looking at this card. There's an actual holo bleed. The entire card is covered in holo. You can kind of see it on the bottom, like by the text, you can see the glare. Cause I put it in the sleeve and I'm like, wait, this is crazy. So I don't know if that means anything, like if it's worth anything, but just the fact that the whole card is holo is kind of neat, and it's not a reverse. And then here we go, our first secret. We got a Weavile, which is only $3.50. I thought it was going to be worth more, but apparently not. I mean, it's nice to always... it's always nice to pull a secret art, but I thought it was going to be worth more than what it was. I mean, at least the Mimikyu was like $9, I think. And the Koffing was about $6. So I have like three secrets from Cosmic Eclipse, but nothing crazy. This is the third pack. Yeah, so I kind of like saw that there was something in this pack. I'm kind of like slow rolling a little bit. And I'm like, oh God, I gotta hesitate a little bit. Because I'm like, what could it be? And then I pulled this. I'm like, oh shit, it's a Charizard Breaks and GX, which this is my first tag team card I've ever pulled because I have never opened really like a lot of Sun and Moon stuff. I was like super excited, like, oh shit, look at this fucking full art, it's so sick. And then I go and look it up and I'm like, oh, it's only $7, because it's like, you know, almost like a VMAX card or something. It's not like the secret one, which would have been amazing, but that's my luck. I don't get anything fucking good. Nothing for you guys to go absolutely wild about. It's so depressing sometimes. It's like, why do I even bother? Whatever. Alright, so pack number four. We got Ducklett, Apom, Krikatot, Florigus. I was like, oh, that's a rare. You know how Cool Trainer Ryan likes to do that. But I don't do anything with him. And then a Buzzwole holo, which doesn't have a holo bleed like that Solgaleo. And then, yeah, our last pack of Cosmic Eclipse. I'm really hoping that I can find some tomorrow, but we'll see. We got Trapinch, Nuttu, Sneasel, Flabébé, Eevee, Onix Reverse, and a non-holo Raichu. So out of five packs, we got only one non-holo, which is kind of crazy to me. But, you know. And then here, this is when I start losing my shit. Because I'm like, what? It really is disappointing to like watch all of these like other YouTubers, and they always seem to pull like these fucking crazy packs and like crazy cards. And it's just like, why can't I? Like, I just feel like it'll help the channel. I'm like, oh shit, people will engage, right? No, it's just like I'm fucking doomed to fail, and I just like, I'm so sick of it sometimes. Like, clearly I'm so exhausted. It is just, I don't know. Literally, that's it. I'm like, I don't even know anymore. But yeah, thanks for getting through this video. I know it wasn't like the best, but if you guys could subscribe, like the video, comment if you guys can find these in the wild, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. See ya.